This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In addition to the last video, in this video, we are going to solve another application by applying the general expression of Newton's second law and the principle of conservation of linear momentum. Application 2. A bullet of mass M1 equals 50 grams, moving horizontally at a speed of V bullet equals 600 meters per second, strikes a stationary wooden block of mass M2 equals 2 kilograms, resting on a smooth horizontal surface. Stationary block means it is initially at rest. The bullet becomes embedded in the block. Embedded means the block and the bullet move as one body after collision with the same velocity V. Now, determine the speed of the system bullet block right after collision. We know that during collision, the linear momentum of the system bullet block is conserved. So, P system just before collision is equal to that right after collision. Now, P system before collision is equal to M1 V bullet, which is the linear momentum of the bullet, plus zero, which is the linear momentum of the block, since it is at rest, so this linear momentum is equal to zero. And P system after the collision is equal to M1 plus M2 times V. M1 plus M2 is the total mass of the system, and V is the velocity of the system after collision. So rearrange V equal M1 over M1 plus M2 times the velocity of the bullet. But we want to determine the magnitude of V. So the magnitude of V equal M1 over M1 plus M2 times the speed of the bullet. Now substitute for M1 equal 0.05 kilogram, M2 equal 2 kilogram, V bullet equal 600 meters per second. Finally, we get the speed of the system after collision, which is equal to 14.63 meters per second.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, part 2. The duration of the collision is 1 millisecond. Use dp by dt is equal to delta p by delta t to determine the average magnitude of the force F bullet block exerted by the bullet on the block during the collision. Now, take into account that you can't take your system as the block and the bullet, because in this case, the force F bullet block would be an internal force acting inside the system. If you want this force to be an external force, you must take the system as the block only. Now, what are the external forces acting on the block? So we have its weight M2g, the normal force exerted by the ground, and the force F bullet block. Now, let's apply the general form of Newton's second law. So this is going to be M2G plus N plus F bullet block is equal to dP block by dt. Now look at the figure. MG and N are vertical forces, say that they do not participate in the horizontal motion of the block. So M2G plus N is equal to zero. This is going to be F bullet block is equal to dP block by dt. Now let's use this given. So replace dp by dt by delta p over delta t. Now, what is meant by delta p? It is the variation in the linear momentum of the block. So delta p block is equal to p final minus p initial. So we have F bullet block is equal to P block final minus P block initial over delta T. You know that P block initial is equal to zero because the block was initially at rest before the collision. So we still have F bullet block is equal to P block final over delta T. And we transform to the algebraic form. Now, P block final is equal to M block times V over delta T. Replace each physical quantity by its value. The mass of the block is 2 kilograms. V is already calculated. It is 14.63 meters per second, and the duration of the collision is 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. The answer is 29.3 times 10 to the power 3 newtons. Now, the weight of the block is 20 newtons, which is much, much less than 29.3 times 10 to the power 3 newtons. Just to remind you that in collisions, the internal forces are much, much stronger than any other external forces. Let's move to part 3. Deduce the average magnitude of the force exerted by the block on the bullet during the collision. So we have the magnitude of the force exerted by the bullet on the block, and we want the force by the block on the bullet. According to Newton's third law, when a block A exerts a force on block B, then simultaneously block B exerts a force on block A, such that these forces have opposite directions and same magnitude. So, according to Newton's third law, F bullet on a block is equal to the negative F block on bullet, but they have the same magnitude. So the magnitude of the force exerted by the block on the bullet is equal to the magnitude of the force exerted by the bullet on the block, which is equal to 29.3 times 10 to the power 3 newtons.
Question number 4. Specify whether the above collision is elastic. To specify whether this collision is elastic, you just have to calculate the kinetic energy of the system before collision and that after collision. If they are equal, so the collision is elastic. If they are not, the collision is inelastic. Now, let's calculate the kinetic energy of the system before collision. Ke before equal Ke bullet plus zero. Since the block is initially at rest, so it has no kinetic energy before collision. Ke bullet before collision equal 1/2 m1 v1 squared. V1 is the speed of the bullet, which is 600 meters per second. M1 is its mass, which is 0.05 kilogram. So the kinetic energy of the system before collision is equal to 9,000 joules. Now, the kinetic energy of the system after collision equal to the kinetic energy of the bullet after collision plus that of the block after collision. Ke of the bullet after collision is equal to 1/2 m1 v squared. V is the speed of the bullet after collision. Similarly, Ke of the block after collision is 1/2 m2 times V squared. Rearrange by taking 1/2 V squared as a common factor. So we get Ke after equal 1/2 into M1 plus M2 V squared. Now substitute for M1 equal 0.05 kilogram, M2 equal 2 kilogram, and V equal 14.63 meters per second. Finally, we get the result. The kinetic energy of the system after collision is equal to 219.39 joules. Comparing the kinetic energy of the system after collision to that before collision, we can find that Ke after less than Ke before. That means the collision is inelastic.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.